Preparations for FRAM 2014-15 were frantic. The first stage consisted of finally repairing the clutch, which had failed twice.
We're preparing for a major expedition in the Arctic Ocean. To do that, we need to have the hovercraft have a major look through in all respects. And we could have done that in Longyearbyen, where the craft is kept, but we decided that it would be better to get it down to Bergen. And we have placed it right in the middle of a scrap metal yard. There are different ways of looking at the scrap metal yard. I prefer to look at it as a resource, place of resources. The main challenge we had was that the clutch that was fitted on the craft originally has given us problems, and now we wanted to have it completely removed and installed a more direct drive. And right now I'm going to start up the engine and we'll let it run. It's a new belt, so I think it has to be run in for a while, so we need to put some hours on it. My wife took it surprisingly well. I think we've been married, 47 years, and if you made it through 47 years, you can be away for a couple of weekends without major crisis.
And then he starts talking. Yeah, you know, this time it will be a long trip. Okay. Yeah. What about Christmas? Are you going to have Christmas dinner with you? He got very quiet. Yes. He thought I was going to make a tantrum, but I took the inner wing on him. Of course, I will miss him. There's no discussion about that. But I know too that that is his dream, and it's the last time he has a chance to do it. And I can't say no.
Yngve then had several months for keeping it in Bergen and, while living on it in the junkyard, completing the preparation of all the equipment that he had designed and built.
So the sail will be around here and be braced up here. So this is the counterforce. So when it fires, the sail will prevent it from going up the core pipe will go like a projectile into the seabed. So it comes back with a 3 meter section of the sub-bottom sediments. We know that the rate of deposition in the Arctic Ocean is roughly 1 centimeter per 1,000 year. So if we have 3 meter, we have roughly 300,000 years represented. So this means that we actually have a storybook of the last 300,000 years.
The next stage consisted of taking the hovercraft from Bergen by sea up to Tromsø, together with all the supplies that Yngve had collected, basically the contents of two containers.
To find somebody to go along on the trip has been not an easy task. Because my past experience in life tells me that you may think you know people, but when they come under pressure, things that you'd never dreamt of comes to the surface. This is not easy. And to start with, the preference would be that it was a scientist. I ended up finding nobody, so it has to be a non-scientist, but a person who has Arctic experience, and has demonstrated that he's robust enough that he can take you know, the dark season, because the first part will be the dark season, which is a challenge.
Well, since I was young, I was always in the outdoors. I've been always you know, liked the outdoors. Yeah, as a kid, we went out skiing, you know, sleeping outside in the snow, and we just enjoyed it. The polar bear is a very beautiful, beautiful animal, and I believe it's very well adapted to its environment. It's walking around looking for opportunities, and as long as you tell the polar bear early enough, it's not an you're not an opportunity, they normally will back off, and I'm not very afraid of the polar bear. I read a lot about the Norwegian Arctic heroes, you know, from Roald Amundsen and Fridtjof Nansen, and what they did in those days. It's not many opportunities these days to, you know, take part of a longer expedition with a good purpose. I mean, to, you know, to find or to find new things. No, I'm quite confident. I am able to take care of myself in if I'm in out in the snow and or ice. As long as you got food and fuel, you should be able to. You always get water on the ice.
The goal of the entire expedition is it's twofold. So it's, first of all, it's mainly a giant geoscientific expedition. That means 99% of the objectives are related to either seismic survey or geological sampling. 50, 60 million years ago, there was this transition, and first sea ice was built, and we would like to study the early history, the change from a warm ice-free Arctic to an ice-covered cold Arctic. This is mainly the geology, paleoceanography group who is interested in that, and then the geophysics group is also interested in the tectonic history of the Arctic. We leave these two people alone for a year or so, and we go away with our big ship, and we have a doctor on board, and they are just by themselves. So it's a little bit a bad feeling, I would say.
About 2 weeks into the Polar Stern cruise, they discovered that it was just impossible to get up on the Alpha Ridge. This is an area of multi-year ice, and the ice conditions were just too hard. As a result, Yngve reports that he was invited up to the chief scientist cabin, and Rüdiger Stein explained that since they couldn't get into the Alpha Ridge, he would be left off in an alternative place. And that place would be the crestal regions of the Lomonosov Ridge, which was the target of our 2012 expedition, which was cut short by the horrific storm, which reduced visibility to almost nothing and resulted in a tremendous amount of rubble ice. While the Polar Stern was plowing north, Yngve sent us a message from 43 miles from the North Pole. And I just want to read one paragraph here. Maybe it has not sunk in with you, but this is a chance bigger than we ever have had. Sababa may be the one that brings representation of Mesozoic stratigraphy to the world scientific community, not icebreakers or drill ships. I get numb by the thought, and it will take all the willpower we may have. The deepest target is nearly at 5,000 meters depth.
Low temperature is one thing, but the wind chill is another thing. This is a thing that actually gets you, you know, if it's cold. And for this reason, we will build a hangar. We will use of this material, plywood, and I would we would make four rods, sort of spacers here. So this is a frame. So you place it here, and you fill it with snow and pour water in it so it freezes to a wall. And you know, you make it this wide, probably. And with this plywood for a frame, you move it up. You know, once this freezes, you move it up and just continue to pour snow in here and pack it and pour water. So in this way you build up the wall.
The approximate weight of the walls of some 30 tons resulted in the 1 meter thick ice flow submerging. So they had 50 centimeters of seawater on the deck. And the net result was they had to abandon the hangar, which later was cut in half by a crack. And since that time, they've been operating out of the hovercraft itself, as well as a small tent.
To prepare for an expedition like this, and particularly for an expedition of this length, we're talking about a year, year and a half. You know, you have to have a setup that you estimate that certain things can go wrong, but there will always be fallback positions that can get you out of it.
On the other hand, one of the course that they took wound up getting a very interesting piece, and they sent a picture back, and this will be good for analysis. Beyond that, they have constructed a bottom camera, and they've taken a very interesting picture of a great amount of biology fish, a large fish, half meter long, swimming along, and all kinds of darting things, which are probably amphipods. In other words, shrimp-like creatures. One of the high points was an email saying that they are in perpetual darkness, the Arctic winter, and all of a sudden they had seen a light. When this light persisted, they then went to it, and it was about 3 miles away. And as they got closer and closer, they noticed that this was a submarine conning tower, which was stuck up through the ice. And that they could make out figures that were up on the submarine sail. They did take pictures of it, and we got a very nice outline of the submarine. And as soon as they got within 100 meters of the submarine blew its tanks and disappeared. I just hope that all of our efforts are going to lead to a very successful conclusion what we were planning, and I wish the two guys out there the very, very, very best.